We researched over 50 different gaming mouse pads you can buy in 2021, then bought the 9 best for a head-to-head comparison to find out which mouse pad will up your game. We spent hundreds of hours playing games, not to mention incorporating each pad into our different gaming setups. In addition to comparing their size, we also carefully tested how loud each pad is, along with ranking them on their speed and control. Continue reading to see which pad claimed the top spot, which is your best bet on a budget, and which one is best for lighting up your desk. The first product on our list is Cooler Master MP510. Our favorite gaming mouse pad is the Cooler Master MP510. Offered in sizes from small to extended, you're sure to find one that suits your mouse sensitivity and available desk space. We appreciated that the logo is smooth on the pad, as it doesn't impede your mouse movement as raised logos sometimes do. The stitched edges also add extra durability to this model, and if you're prone to spilling drinks, you'll appreciate the splash-proof surface. There are some slight downsides to this model. If you like to use your whole arm for movements, the rougher feel of the Corsair fabric might be irritating. The Corsair fabric might also wear down the skates on your mouse faster than you'd like. If you want great control and don't mind the rough material, the Cooler Master MP510 is our top recommendation for a speed pad. The second product is Corsair MM300 Extended. The Corsair MM300 Extended is our top choice if you're looking for an extended gaming mouse pad. The surface area is more than a standard medium mouse pad, despite a full-size keyboard and macro buttons on the side. The printed-on logo and graphics don't obstruct your mouse in any way, which we like. There are multiple sizes available, including small, medium, and standard, to ensure the MM300 fits your desk as needed. There aren't any major setbacks on this model that we could find. We did notice that the color of the mouse pad we received was slightly off from the one displayed online. Thankfully, we didn't receive a rust-colored pad as some customers griped, but ours did look lighter than the black we expected from the advertisement. We also saw a lot of reviews that protested a strong odor. Fortunately for us and most users, that was not the case. Those minor annoyances aside, the Corsair MM300 is an excellent extended mouse pad. The next product is Logitech G440 HOD. The Logitech G440 HOD gaming mouse pad is an outstanding choice if you are shopping for a HOD mouse pad. It's practical and uncomplicated. You don't need to power any flashy lights or deal with additional cables, simplifying your setup. The low friction surface of this model made it one of the fastest in our testing. We also like that the logo is printed beneath the covering. Like most HOD mouse pads, the G440 is easy to wipe clean if you spill food or liquids on it. The G440, however, is not without its drawbacks. The edges on this pad are somewhat sharp, so large, quick movements could scrape up your wrist or forearm if not wearing long sleeves. We really wish that, at minimum, the edges were beveled. All mouse pads, even cloth ones, get broken in, but this was much more noticeable on this model because the texture wore away quickly, causing tracking issues with the surface on unseen dust. The Logitech G440's slick surface and excellent speed make these drawbacks easy to overlook, especially if you find an easy solution to resolve the sharp edge situation. The next product in our list is SteelSeries QCK Medium. Searching for a budget gaming mouse pad? Look no further than the SteelSeries QCK Medium. SteelSeries offers a wide variety of sizes and styles of this pad, all utilizing the same micro-woven cloth. From small to extended, stitched edges or not, to thick or thin padding, there is a style to suit your preference at a price point lower than most competitors. We found the soft fabric to be quite pleasant and smooth to slide across. As a bonus, it's also washable. Budget options usually have some drawbacks, and the QCK is no exception. For starters, the logo is raised, but thankfully, it isn't so sticky as to immediately stop your mouse. The edges are also not protected, which leaves them susceptible to peeling and fraying. Ours arrived already peeling with frayed edges. All in all, the SteelSeries QCK Medium is a great mouse pad for gaming, especially for its budget price and plethora of available options. The next product is ROCCAT Taito Control. The ROCCAT Taito Control is a solid option if you are looking for a large and durable budget mouse pad. The edges are stitched up with an electric blue thread that provides durability and some sweet aesthetics. We measured the thickness at 4mm with our calipers, and that seemed like plenty of cushion and noise dampening for our testers who frequently pick up their mice. We noticed that the Taito Control would slowly work its way around our desk during gameplay, especially during games with heavy mouse movement. The pad's walking issue may be due to the rubber backing not being the best material for all surface types or the fact that our pad refused to lay completely flat. We use typical smooth top desks for testing. Additionally, we found the logo a bit obstructive, it's large, raised, and spots a rubbery texture. Don't get us wrong, the ROCCAT Taito Control is one of our favorite gaming mouse pads, offering plenty of room and control, but it may take time to get used to working around the logo and finding a solution to the walking problem we experienced. The next product is Zowie GSR. Are FPS games your jam? Then we highly recommend the Zowie GSR for FPS beginners and even veterans. The GSR is a very large mouse pad, offering plenty of room to find a sweet spot of DPI and in-game sensitivity for consistent accuracy. This model stays in place with minimal walking, making it less likely you'll overshoot your target on a quick flick shot. Zowie takes a simplistic approach to gaming equipment, and, as such, they use a small tag sewn in on the edge to display their logo, leaving it well out of the way. We also found this model to be one of the quietest pads tested. It also works great for game genres other than FPS. Although the GSR is a solid mouse pad, it moved around a bit in testing, even with its large size. It wasn't a ton of movement, but by the end of our gaming sessions, we repeatedly had to scoot it back into place. The rubber backing isn't as grippy as some models, but still better than others. We also found that the stitched edges, while high quality, may irritate some users' skin. The same goes for other stitched mouse pads as well. Despite these minor flaws, the Zowie GSR is an exceptional, high-quality gaming mouse pad. The next product in our list is Razer Firefly V2. Looking to add a little flair to your setup? The Razer Firefly V2 is an excellent HOD pad that can do just that with its virtually 360 degrees, fully customizable RGB lighting. Razer has improved on the previous Firefly by adding a low-profile cable hub and a cable cache that's built right in. You can move your mouse effortlessly across the smooth surface without worrying about scratching yourself on a shop lip, thanks to the rounded edge of the LED strip. Unfortunately, the cable hub doesn't support USB pass-through, which means it takes up a precious USB slot. We also found that setting up the lighting the way we wanted it was a little confusing and time-consuming. This nuisance can be avoided by using one of the presets, audio meter, breathing, reactive, spectrum cycling, static, or wave. We also found customer reviews describing tracking issues with their mice on this pad, but none of our six testing mice had any trouble. Overall, the Razer Firefly V2 is a nice HOD pad with some added RGB flair. The next product in our list is Bladehawk's BX04 RGB. If you've noticed that your desk space is lacking or that most extended mouse pads are too large, look no further than the Bladehawk's BX04. It offers good control with the added glamour of RGB lighting. It lets you easily swap through 7 static lighting modes and 3 dynamic modes with the press of a button. You also don't have to worry about the pad peeling or fraying, the light strip is sewn into the edges, reinforcing them considerably. Similar to other RGB pads, the Bladehawk's doesn't offer USB pass-through, so it takes up a USB slot on your computer. The RGB settings are easy to cycle through, but you are limited to the manufacturer's presets without the option to customize. Additionally, we found the stitched edges to be really irritating. One tester complained that the stitches felt like they were made out of fishing line. If you can get past the irritating edge stitching, the Bladehawk's BX04 RGB is a great control pad that won't take up too much space. The next product is Corsair MM800 RGB Polaris. The Corsair MM800 RGB Polaris is a good option for a HOD mouse pad if you want RGB lighting but without sacrificing a USB slot. The built-in USB pass-through for your mouse means that the mouse pad and mouse only take up a single USB slot on your computer. The lighting on this model is also fully customizable and can be adjusted to perfectly match your setup. We found that the rubber base grips most surfaces well, anchoring it in place even during high-intensity moments. There are some downsides to the MM800. The hub for the COD and USB pass-through seem to occasionally get in the way. It is centered on the pad and sticks up above the mouse surface by about 14 millimeters. On two of our test PCs, we discovered that the mouse pad wouldn't connect to the software unless it was plugged into a USB slot on the motherboard but would still light up with the default spiral rainbow. You need to log into the software for the effects to take place. If you don't, the manufacturer default rainbow spiral setting will continuously run. All things considered, the Corsair MM800 RGB Polaris is a decent HOD mouse pad, especially if you have a wireless mouse.
Thanks for watching and hope you liked it. As always, all the links about the products will be in the description below, so if you want to find the best prices and more information that we might not get a chance to mention in the video, be sure to check them out.